Hello, everybody, and welcome to Warrior Friday. We're starting out right now in this position because this beautiful ray of golden sunlight is coming in and I had to share it. So I know you can't see me very well, and besides, you really don't need to see me anyway, but what's important is this beautiful ray of light right here, wherever it is. There it is. It's amazing and glorious. Now, it is really freaking cold here where I'm at in Sauk Center, Minnesota. We're right smack dab in the middle of the state. Really cold, but when the sun's shining, it makes it feel like it's not minus 40. You know, it makes it feel like it's only minus 20. So how are my warriors today? Are you hanging in there? Remember, this is the time where we're supposed to just be. We're supposed to be vibing high. We're supposed to be playing with our crystals and our singing bowls and our tuning forks and our tarot and oracle decks. We're supposed to be learning new things. We're supposed to be meditating, maybe doing yoga or dancing. What are you doing to be you, to be a better you? I asked a very spiritual friend of mine yesterday what he was doing to pass the time while he was stranded at home. And I was thinking, what would I do? Well, I'm not saying I'm stranded here, but I kind of make myself be stranded because it's all about being the bear and being introspective and going inside yourself. Meditating. What can you learn by meditating? What can you learn by receiving information from on high? What can your spirit guides who live in the light teach you? What can your ancestors who live in the light teach you? Are you ready to receive? If you're not, maybe it's time you work on that. Being ready to receive is so important because we as light warriors and healers and empaths tend to not receive. We give, 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 give. But then when it comes time to receiving, we're like, no, I'm okay. No, we need to receive. Big shout out to the young man who came and he brought his own snowblower and he cleaned out my driveway and my sidewalks, never even came in, not even to warm up. He was my guardian angel for the day. And so the old me would be kind of like, no. I mean, I literally would have run out there in my shoes, even though it's super cold, not put boots on, I would have run out there and said, no, stop. The new me is... I sent him a message and I said, thank you for being my guardian angel for the day. See, he gets to be my guardian angel and I get to receive. So everybody gets something out of that situation. It is not a transaction. Relationships are not transactions. It's a situation. I got to receive. I got to experience receiving and learn how to receive one more time. And he got to be the guardian angel. So, I don't know where all that came from. Today's card is from the fabulous Earth Warriors deck. And I had to laugh because, like I said, it's freaking cold outside. And we get card number 25. 2 + 5 = 7, meaning we're on the right path. And this is Aloha Keakua. And so I have to laugh because, you know, this is like from Hawaii where it's warm. So I'm putting the intention out there that this card is going to bring us some warmth. We're not only sitting in this beautiful golden ray of sunshine in the sunroom. This room is called the sunroom because it actually used to be a greenhouse and it's got skylights overhead and it's got all these big windows on the side. And in the morning, the sun comes in here and it's just glorious. And it's funny because I also have a sun right above my head. So this card is Hawaiian, Aloha Keakua, blessings of the supreme being. Okay, so this is some serious stuff. We got to pay attention to this. Aloha Keakua, the divine is love. The supreme being from which all of life emanates manifests a blessing for you. The realm of the heart is love's temple. When you enter the heart, you gain access to the Great One and to the mana, the power, the authority, the grace, and magnetism to manifest your divine destiny. Trust in what is meant for you. Remember, what is meant for you will never ever pass you by. You may not get it today, but maybe 3 weeks from now or 3 years from now. When the stars align, as my friend says, surrender doubt and disconnection in favor of love and respect for the Great One. The Great One, Great Spirit, God, Creator, Source. You shall live your true destiny with joy in your heart. Love can and will conquer all. This is all about love, and that could be self-love. Because when I love myself, I become love, I become a love magnet, and I send it out to everybody around me, whether I know them or not. And then love comes to me. How beautiful is this? And it's, you know, a month from now, a little bit more than a month, we'll have Valentine's Day, which I know it's a really commercialized holiday. I don't even consider it a holiday. It's a commercialized day. But the whole purpose of it for me is to celebrate love. It's not who can spend the most money on the biggest box of chocolates. But if it's good chocolate, just saying, give me a box of rocks and a box of good dark chocolate, I'm happy. But we're supposed to be living in love. Live in love. Fill this heart full of love. No fear. No place for fear. You can either have fear or you can have love. You can never have the two at the same time. So if you're feeling fearful about something, whether it's money or lack of a job or you don't have that special someone in your life, love yourself and become the love magnet. Okay? Feel your heart. Your heart has a magnetic field. Make that magnetic field be full of love, and you will attract the perfect person for you. Now, if you say, oh, you know, universe, bring me the perfect man, or bring me the perfect woman, or whatever, or even the perfect dog or cat, it's not going to work. You know why? Because there is no perfect man, there is no perfect woman, there is no perfect dog, and there is no perfect cat. But there's the perfect man for me, or the perfect woman for me, or the perfect dog for me, or the perfect cat for me, right? The perfect whatever for me. That's totally different than the perfect whatever. See what I'm saying? The perfect man for you, or the perfect woman for you, is totally different than the you over there. So, thank you for bringing me the perfect whatever for me. Or thank you for bringing me all the resources that I need to fulfill my missions and to be filled with love and joy and peace and happiness and success. Resources. Because that's what we all are. We're resources. Money is a resource. A house is a resource. A job is a resource. A car is a resource. A truck is a resource. And yeah, people are resources. Let's continue a little bit more with Aloha Keakua. Sometimes we sense a significant purpose for our lives, a task that could benefit the greatest good. Or there may simply be an issue that you know you need to confront in order to grow spiritually, but your mind is afraid to let go. In such moments of doubt or concern, or even in those perhaps slightly rarer, moments where you may feel like a super being capable of anything at all, it is important to remember the truth about the role of the Supreme Being in our hearts and in our lives. We can never let our egos get the best of us, okay? Tell your ego to step aside. You don't need the ego, okay? This is one of our missions here, is to let that ego go. We don't need to have the most expensive whatever, or the nicest car, or the reddest car, or the fastest car, or whatever. We need to do what we can for the highest and greatest good of all. And my highest and greatest good, mine being, you know, who's ever listening, and be happy and joyful. It doesn't mean having to worship the ego. That's exactly how I want to say it. Stop worshiping the ego. You know, back in the day, if the Joneses got a new house or a new car or a new van or whatever, then, you know, everybody else in the neighborhood felt like they had to do the same thing. No, you don't. Who cares what the Joneses are doing? No offense to anybody out there named Jones. But stop worrying about what your neighbors are doing or saying. Concentrate on you and being the best person you can be. The truth is, we cannot fulfill our divine destinies without mana. This is the authority, grace, and power that the divine has instilled within us, and which will continue to help us cultivate and express through the guidance that we feel in our hearts. So mana from heaven, right? Grace and power and authority from God, Creator, Spirit, the Great One, the Divine. For every purpose that has been given you, there is also the divine gift of the power to accomplish it. It is only through divine relationship that we can tap into these gifts and make the sacred purpose for our lives a reality in this world. So if you've been given this divine inspiration to write a book, you know, all of a sudden you wake up one morning and you're like, I'm going to write a book. I had a dream, or I have this thought. That can be our higher selves giving it to us. God, Creator, Source, Great Spirit. Our spirit guides who live in the light. Whoever it is, you didn't think of it because you weren't thinking it, right? It was given to you. So while you're planning on doing this, talk to them. Say, okay, all right. I'm a vessel. Let's start channeling, baby. My friend Cody Cooper has written, well, 6 books that I know of. I have 6 of his books on my shelves here. And I'm very blessed to have edited several of his books. And I got to see the progression. So I know he wrote the very first book. But the 6th book, when it came time to channeling it, I called him on the phone and I said, who really wrote this? And he said, why do you say that? And I said, because this isn't you. You channeled this. So who were you channeling? Were you channeling the Pleiadians? And he went, yeah. You can tell? And I said, oh, gosh, yeah. The writing style is totally different. So don't be surprised if when you're channeling, which is to step aside and allow the divine to come in, that you're doing something that you wouldn't normally do. Whether it's writing a book or making candles or working with wood, all of a sudden you're doing something that you didn't even know you knew how to do. How cool is that? I didn't even know I could channel. One day, I just started channeling and it was really weird. And it was in the middle of the day when the store was open. Actually, we had a solar eclipse and it was right during the solar eclipse. And I started channeling for this customer that was standing there. And I remember standing over in the corner. My spirit was standing over in the corner. My body was here and there were words coming out. And I remember being over there and watching and being here and having, you know, the mannerisms. And I was like, what the heck is this? This is so cool. So don't be surprised if things like that are happening with you. There's so much going on right now. the way the planetary alignment is, what part of the solar system we're moving through. All these things are happening, and they have an effect on the Earth. Frequencies are going up. Well, actually, frequencies go like this. A lot of stuff going on. Veil is getting thinner, and we are waking up. So if we're waking up and all this stuff is going on, don't be surprised if you have people coming to you in your dreams. You're receiving messages. You are, you're getting signs all over the place. You're doing things you wouldn't normally do. You're feeling elated for no reason, or crabby for no reason. If you're an empath and there's stuff going on in the world and you can feel it and you don't even know if you can feel it, but you're all of a sudden crying for no reason, it's because something happened. Like, was it Wednesday night? I think it was Wednesday night. I don't remember if it was Tuesday night or Wednesday night, but something must have happened somewhere in the world, which was bad, because I was bawling my head off in the evening, and I knew it wasn't mine. And to me, when that happens, it means there's great loss. There's some strife, some drama that's going on, and I can feel it. And so I have to cry for the world. And I know there's other people out there that do that as well. And it's good. It's good because we're like a release valve, kind of like where you've got a volcano and then you have all these little points. I can't think of what they're called right now, but they're like release valves. So they're letting off steam over here so the big volcano doesn't blow. So I feel like I'm one of those, and I have to cry for the world sometimes. But the cool thing is, when I'm crying for the world, I'm also releasing my own angst. And as we cry, we're releasing emotional toxins and physical toxins. So we actually benefit when we cry for the world. So keep that in mind. The next time you're crying and you don't know why, it's because there's something going on somewhere and you're just feeling it. So cry and let it out. It's so funny because when I'm talking, I don't know why I'm saying the things I'm saying. Getting back to channeling and doing other things. If you are all of a sudden not liking the foods that you used to like, or you're liking new foods, like somebody yesterday was telling me her favorite desserty thing now is baked kale. And I was like, okay, that's really weird. I mean, my favorite thing is chocolate, so it doesn't matter if it's dessert or the meal. That hasn't changed. But if your eating habits have changed, it's because your body is changing. You need to eat lighter. I know I can go all day now without eating, and I never used to be able to do that. I can go a whole day where I don't even go, oh, I'm hungry. As long as I'm drinking my water, I'm good. So just know that our bodies are changing. Our emotional state is changing. If you can hear what other people are thinking or feeling, you're not going crazy. This is where we're all headed. We are all in a transformational state, and we are one. And this is why we need to be kind to each other, because if we're kind to each other and we feel each other, there's no strife, there's no drama, right? So let's all be kind to each other. Know that you are receiving all kinds of really cool gifts from the universe. Play with them. If you're channeling, play with it. But remember, only channel beings from the light. Be very, very specific about who you channel. Okay? I only work with beings from the light, because I don't want to watch my life go down the toilet. Okay? Just saying. I got stories about all that stuff. So if you really want to work with dark entities, you go for it. But then don't come running to me for help later. All right, that is our video today, my beautiful light warriors. I love you guys. The ray of sunshine has moved Oh, sad face. I'll have to find it later. Anyway, be a beautiful shining ray of light like you are. And remember, lighthouses do not go out seeking boats and ships. Think about that. If you're a light warrior or a lighthouse, you don't need to go out and seek others. They'll find you. And your job is to have boundaries. Big rocks. Big boulders all the way around you, or a beach or something. Anyway, have a beautiful, blessed, amazing day. Stay warm. And I send you blessings of love, light, peace, joy, happiness, success, and divine health, and all good things, because you are worthy and you deserve them all. Mwah! I love you guys. Namaste.